We'll work with four players in yellow, four players in green, and two players in blue. The ones in blue are basically midfielders, okay? We have four squares over here. I want one green and one yellow in each square. One green and one yellow, one green and one yellow, one green and one yellow, and one green and one yellow.
The beauty of this way of sync training is the fact that we train in the same exercise, we train so many things. It's different, it's difficult to say the objective of this exercise is this one, because it's so rich.
We'll do it like this. The players in blue are the ones creating superiority because the four in yellow and the four in green can't come out of their square. The players in blue are the ones who can move freely inside all four squares. That is to say, the blue players can create a 3-to-1 situation. For example, André passes the ball to the ones in yellow, the yellow player has the ball. Right now, only the green player is playing here, but the blue ones can join him. So it's 3-to-1. The goal is not having 3-to-1 during 10 minutes. It's to create superiority. One pass, two passes, and you turn around and go away. Or you can play here, 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 and here. The players in blue, which are midfielders, they like to play, they like to have the ball, they like to put the ball on the ground. You must have a good dynamics to the exercise. It's the players in blue who manage to do that, passing the ball around. We play and play and we move around. When the other team manages to intercept it, it's great. But if you can't do it, when we start again, the ball goes to the team which didn't have it. And that's not a problem. The goal is to create space and not allowing to be marked. Okay, yellow ball, play.
A global situation of 6 against 4 and subdivided in some sequences of 3 against 1, because the objective is to develop in the boys the ball possession capacity. The notion of I need a lot of movement to create superiority situations. The two kids playing as jokers are kids with a bigger tendency to be midfield players, which are normally the players with more touches in the ball, more capacity to organize.
Go! Take it away!
Because in the same exercise, the exercise was static, because they had a tactical thinking in relation to the exercise. The exercise was technical, because they need a good control, a good coordination, a good passing, a good movement, and was physical, because it was very, very demanding. The exercise was so specific that they were working everything.
More dynamic. Oh, you see? Stop it. Do you see what happened now? If he had managed to keep possession, you'd be here and the yellow one would be very close to you, so he wouldn't have any passing options. He couldn't play with you. You're on the line and he's with you. When you see the ball getting near, try and create space over there. You have to create space. It's better to create space outside and then tag inside, and then to be already inside. And André, pass it to the green one.
They were breaking, they were turning, they were sprinting, they were changing direction, they couldn't stop. Even the players not involved directly with the ball, they had to be always in permanent movement to receive the ball or to try to control the movement of a player that wants to be free to receive the ball. And by the physical point of view, the exercise was so demanding.
That's it. Nice. Nice, that's it.
Jogado.
Go, Bruno.
E fala, Bruno. Bem.
Good.
Okay, joga amarelo.
Okay, yellow. Communicate. Do you want to play or not? Do you want the ball? Green? Green?
Okay, joga amarelo.
Yellow. Yellow, you're losing the ball. Occupy some space. Well played. Play it here. Put it here. That's it.
Jogado. Isso é bem.
Well played. That's good. That's good. Play, Marluka. Let's go, João. Don't lose that ball. Don't lose it. Don't lose it, yellow. Play, yellow. Play.
Jogado.
Nice.
E falar.
Speak so you can change the game orientation. He needs it. He was needing some backup. Yellow and green. Good, good. Turn around. Speak immediately so he can turn around. Play, André. Take it. That's it. That's it. Let's go. That's nice. That's it. Well played. Pass it to João. Well played, André.
Okay. I could easily feel that some of the kids were getting really tired with the exercise, which is absolutely normal. That's why even with adults, we need to control in this kind of exercise, we need to control the time of the exercise, the space of the exercise, the number of players involved in the exercise, the number of repetitions, the time in between repetitions, because we can achieve so many different physical qualities. And if the period of recovery is a complete period where you recover completely and you start the next repetition completely fine, is one objective. If you decided, no, I don't want a complete recuperation, I just want a little period for a different kind of adaptation, the exercise is so rich. It's enough for us to know our players. Is not enough. We must know them very, 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 very well. And in kids is even more important. We need to know them very, very well to give them what they need. Father is a father, but a coach is also a coach. I think a coach can play a part in the kids. And we can establish with them such a trustful relation that is very important for them. I think to work in the same exercise, all the experts, all the components of the development of the boy, I think is fundamental. They are working the psychological side, but they don't know which one is more comfortable under pressure, which one accepts in a better way the competition, which one feels more the pressure and makes mistakes when the pressure from the outside starts, which one is a perfectionist and is not happy because he made a mistake, which one makes the mistake and laugh, which one makes the mistake and is complaining with himself, which one makes the mistake and is complaining with the crosser of the ball that had a great cross, but he says the cross was not good. So if we have attention on this, and the youth coach must be completely focused on this side of the boys, you can, in early ages, you can attack immediately the quality that doesn't look so good.